जय श्री गुरुदेव। गुड मॉर्निंग टू एवरीवन फ्रेंड्स। आफ्टर नोइंग द पोस्टुलेट्स ऑफ डाल्टन एटॉमिक थ्योरी एंड वी गेट एन आइडिया अबाउट ऑफ एन एटम एंड एलिमेंट्स और मॉलिक्यूल्स, वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी द एटॉमिक एंड मॉलिक्यूलर मासेस ऑफ एन एटम्स, दैट इज एटॉमिक एंड मॉलिक्यूलर मासेस ऑफ एन एटम एंड एलिमेंट। नाउ टेक फर्स्ट वन, एटॉमिक मास। Atomic mass. You know, atom is an extremely small in size. Extremely small in size. Therefore, it is difficult to weigh it, or to measure the radius of an atom. Therefore, to overcome all those problems, we are taking carbon 12 as an template, a standard one. Carbon 12 as a standard one, because the carbon 12 containing exactly 12 atomic mass unit of numbers. 12 atomic mass unit of numbers. Hence, this carbon 12 is taken as a standard template. By using this one, we can calculate the atomic masses of the Hall element. Atomic masses of the Hall element. Therefore, the atomic mass of an element or atomic mass of an atom is defined as a mass exactly equal to 1/12th of the mass of one carbon atom. 1/12th of the mass of one carbon 12 atom. One carbon 12 atom, that is atomic mass is defined as mass is defined as mass of a mass exactly equal to a mass exactly equal to 1/12th of exactly equal to 1/12th of the 12th of the atom of 1/12th of the atom of mass of 1/12th of the atom mass of one carbon atom or one carbon atom, that is the mass of one carbon atom, the mass of one carbon atom, the mass of one carbon atom is called atomic mass. That is, atomic mass is defined as a mass exactly equal to 1/12th of the mass of one carbon atom. Mass of one carbon atom. That is, the atomic mass of one carbon atom is given by the atomic mass of one carbon atom. That is, in terms of atomic mass units, atomic mass. It is represented as AMU, that is one atomic mass is equal to 1.66036 atomic mass unit. 1660 into 10 power minus 24 grams. 10 power minus 24 grams. This is one atomic mass. One atomic mass is equal to 1.66056 into 10 power minus 24 grams. Therefore, the mass of an atom of hydrogen, by using this, the mass of an atom of a hydrogen is given by the mass of an atom of a hydrogen atom is equal to 1.67036 into 10 power minus 24 grams. 10 power minus 24 grams. That is, atom is 1.67036 into 10 power minus 24 grams. This is an mass of one hydrogen atom. Therefore, the mass of hydrogen atoms in expressed in terms of atomic mass units is equal to that is mass of hydrogen atoms in terms of atomic mass units. He is in terms of atomic mass units. He is equal to atomic mass units. That is 1. This is mass of a hydrogen atom. 1.67036 into 10⁻²⁴ grams whole divided by this is the one atomic mass units formed by the carbon 12. From the carbon 12, we are determining the weight or mass of one atomic mass unit. That is, one atomic mass unit is equal to 1.66056 into 10⁻². This is the actual mass of a hydrogen atom. Now this is divided by 1.66056 into 10⁻². Grams. Now 10⁻², 24 get cancelled. Divide 1.67036 divided by 1.66056. You get a value like that is 1.008 atomic mass units. This is the mass of hydrogen atom in terms of atomic mass units. So now atomic mass units are measured by the hydrogen atom. The 1.008 atomic mass units. Okay, 1.08 atomic mass units. This is the mass of hydrogen atom. Mass of hydrogen atom. And nowadays the atomic mass units is replaced by writing U. That is 1.008 atomic mass units can be written as 1.008 U. When U is called unified mass. Nowadays, the atomic mass units can be written as U. That is, when U is called what? Unified mass. Unified mass. Both are same. Just we are changing the term by AMU to U. That is, unified mass. This is the concept of atomic mass. So, how do you get the atomic mass concept? Because the atom is extremely small. And it is difficult to weigh the compound or to measure the mass of an atom or radius. To overcome those problems, we are taking carbon 12 is a standard one because it containing 12 atomic mass units exactly for an atom. Therefore, atomic mass is defined as the mass exactly equal to 1 by 12 of carbon 12 isotope. 1 by 12 of mass of carbon 12 isotope. That is carbon atom. Therefore, one atomic mass unit is found by this definition 1.66056 into 10⁻². Grams. And the mass of hydrogen atom is given by or found to be 1.67036 in 10⁻². This is found by spectroscopically. After found this value, we are converting the atomic mass units, the hydrogen mass into the terms of atomic mass unit. That is, by dividing this 1.67 divided by 1.66, you get 1.008 atomic mass unit. This is the mass of an hydrogen atom. Okay. Now let's take molecular mass. So after knowing the atomic mass concept, then next one, average atomic mass. Before going to molecular mass, take the next concept, average atomic mass. Average atomic mass. Here observe many naturally occurring elements are formed in the form of their isotopes. Therefore, to find the atomic masses of such elements, we are overcoming the masses of all those elements based on the abundance or relative abundance or available percentage of an isotopes. So, ಏನ ಹೇಳ್ತಿದೀವಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಆವರೇಜ್ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಮಾಸ್ ಅನ್ನೋ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಬಂತು. ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಯಾವಾಗಲೇ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಮಾಸ್ ಅನ್ನೋದು ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತು. ಸೊ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಮಾಸ್ ಇಸ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ದಿ ಮಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ 1/12 ಆಫ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ 12 ಐಸೋಟೋಪ್ಸ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆವರೇಜ್ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಮಾಸ್. ದೆನ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಆವರೇಜ್ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಮಾಸ್. So average atomic mass is nothing but many naturally occurring elements. Naturally occurring elements. So example, the naturally occurring elements like take hydrogen or carbon or nitrogen or chloride etc. All these are naturally occurring elements. These elements occur in many isotopes. These are not occur exactly in the form of hydrogen or carbon, nitrogen or chlorine. This hydrogen may occur in the form of H1, that is called protonium, and H2 is called deuterium, this is called protonium, and this is called deuterium, and H3, this is called tritium. Like this hydrogen is occurring in these three forms. All these we call what? Isotopes. All these three called isotopes. Similarly, the carbon is also occur in the form of its isotope. Isotopes, its isotopes, those are carbon 12 isotope and carbon 13 isotope and carbon 14 isotopes, and all these are not occurring same percentage or not abundant in same percentage. Andre ivellannu onde percentage alli sigodilla. Like for example, this carbon 12 isotope is occur 98%. 98%, that is 98.892%. This is the occurrence. Then carbon 13 isotope is occur 1.108. This is the abundance. It is a less abundant element. And the carbon 14 is too much less abundant element. That is 2×10⁻¹. This much percentage. So observe here the availability means abundance. Andre sigoantaddu. ಎಷ್ಟು ಪರ್ಸೆಂಟೇಜ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇದೆ? ಕಡಿಮೆ ಪರ್ಸೆಂಟೇಜ್ ಇದೆ. ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿದೆ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ 12. ಓಕೆ, ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಐಸೋಟೋಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದೀಸ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್. ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ಲಿ ಟೇಕ್ ನೈಟ್ರೋಜನ್. ದಿಸ್ ನೈಟ್ರೋಜನ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಅವೈಲೇಬಲ್ ಇನ್ ಟೂ ಐಸೋಟೋಪ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಸ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನೈಟ್ರೋಜನ್ 14 ಅಂಡ್ ನೈಟ್ರೋಜನ್ 13. ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಟೂ ಐಸೋಟೋಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ನೈಟ್ರೋಜನ್. ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ಲಿ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ಲೋರಿನ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಅವೈಲೇಬಲ್ ಆರ್ ಅಬೌಂಡೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ಟೂ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಐಸೋಟೋಪ್ಸ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕ್ಲೋರಿನ್ 35 and chlorine 37. These are the two isotopes of isotopes of chlorine. Like that you get many isotopes. These are all naturally occurring elements. Now in such cases, to find the atomic masses of these elements or such kind of elements like hydrogen, carbon, nitrogen, chlorine etc. or oxygen, now we are summing the masses of all these elements based on their abundance. ಇಂಥ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ಗೆ ನಾವು ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಮಾಸಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ, ಈ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸು ಎಷ್ಟೆಷ್ಟು ಪರ್ಸೆಂಟೇಜ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ನೋಡ್ಕೊಂಡ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಅವುಗಳ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಮಾಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಸಮ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಕೂಡಿಸ್ತೀವಿ. ಕೂಡಿಸಿದಾಗ ಬರುವಂತ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಮಾಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ಏನಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ, ಆವರೇಜ್ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಮಾಸ್. ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಸಮ್ಮಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಮಾಸಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದೀಸ್ ಎಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಬೇಸ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ ದೇರ್ ಅಬೌಂಡೆನ್ಸ್, ದಿ ರಿಸಲ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆವರೇಜ್ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಮಾಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆವರೇಜ್ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಮಾಸ್. ನೌ ಟೇಕ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ 12. ಯು ನೋ ದಿ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಮಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ 12, ಆರ್ ಟು ಫೈಂಡ್ ದಿ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಮಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ 12 ಐಸೋಟೋಪ್, ಲೆಟ್ ಟೇಕ್ ದಿ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ 12. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಐಸೋಟೋಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ 12. Isotopes of carbon 12, that is, take there are three isotopes of carbon, carbon 12 and carbon 13, then carbon 14. These are the three isotopes of carbon. Then relative abundance. Relative abundance means ಎಷ್ಟು ಪರ್ಸೆಂಟೇಜ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ಐ ರಿಟನ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ರಿಲೇಟಿವ್ ಅಬೌಂಡೆನ್ಸ್, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ರಿಟನ್ ಇನ್ ಪರ್ಸೆಂಟೇಜಸ್, ಗೆಟ್ 98.892. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅವೈಲೇಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ 12, ಅಂಡ್ ದಿ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ 13 ಇಸ್ 1.108, ಅಂಡ್ ದಿ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ 14 ಇಸ್ 2×10⁻¹. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿ ರಿಲೇಟಿವ್ ಅಬೌಂಡೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ 12, 13 ಅಂಡ್ 14 ಐಸೋಟೋಪ್. Now write atomic mass in terms of atomic mass units. Now atomic mass in terms of atomic mass units. This is the terms of atomic mass. We write in the atomic masses of these elements. These elements na atomic mass na barikuni based on this relative abundance. Now the carbon 12 having atomic mass 12 exactly. कार्बन ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಮಾಸ್ ಎಷ್ಟು 12 ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಈ ಒಂದು ಐಸೋಟೋಪ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ 13 ರಿಂದ ನಾವು ದಿ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಮಾಸ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ದಿಸ್ ಐಸೋಟೋಪ್ ಇಸ್ ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಲೇನರ್ ಜಿ 13 ಇದೆ 12 ಇದೆ ಸೋ ಒಂದ ಐಸೋಟೋಪ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ 1.008 ಇಷ್ಟು ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ಇಷ್ಟು ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಆಯ್ತು ಅದೇ ರೀತಿ ದಿಸ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸಸ್ ಬೈ 1.008 ಮಚ್ means that much increases this carbon therefore you get for carbon 13.0035 for carbon 13 isotope similarly for carbon 14 isotope you get exactly 14.001 this is the availability of carbon 14 isotope at 14.0031 this is the availability of sorry atomic masses of these element atomic masses of these element now to find the average atomic mass we have all these atomic masses with the relative abundance in the multiply madkonda atomic masses anna wo sum madadaga ali barutte is average atomic mass okay now we get average atomic mass so observe to find the average atomic mass take average atomic mass is equal to ke relative abundance is by percentage kottidivi andre en madbeku this is divided by 100 madkobeku so after dividing 98.89 divided by 100 how much you get 0.98892 okay 0.9892 you get after dividing is 98.89 divided by 100 because here we are writing in percentage form which is multiplied by 12 atomic mass units or this is also represented in the terms of unified mass u u antane heltive athava 12 antane heltive so average atomic mass is equal to 0.98892 because we are dividing by 100 here there is a percentage into the what is the atomic mass of carbon 12 into 12 plus now the relative abundance of carbon 13 is how much 1.108 divided by 100 after dividing 100 how much you get 0.01108 after dividing this one divided by 100 you get 0.1108 which is multiplied by how much 13.0035 it is 13.0035 plus here there is 2 into 10 power minus 2 which is divided by 100 this is divided by 100 okay so after dividing 100 you get 0.002 or 100 is equal to what 10 power minus plus 2 if you take numerator you get 10 power minus 2 so 10 power plus 2 10 power minus 2 is becomes 10 power minus 12 like that either you write in form of power or divide these terms you get the value so after dividing 2 divided by 100 how much you get 0.02 into 10 power minus 10 minus 10 and which is multiplied by 14.0037 that is 14.00317 okay this is the multiplication now add these all by multiplying all these and add you get exactly 12.011 atomic mass 12.011 atomic mass units or unified mass to get this value this is called what average atomic mass okay now after knowing average atomic mass we are going to molecular mass the next concept is molecular mass after knowing atomic mass and average atomic mass the next is molecular mass so molecular mass is defined as sum of the masses of atoms of an element present in a molecule that is molecular mass is defined as is defined as sum of sum of atomic masses of all atoms of any all atoms of an element of an element in a molecule. A molecule is called molecular mass. Is called molecular mass. So molecular mass is defined as sum of atomic masses of elements in a molecule. Is called molecular mass. Molecular mass. This is the definition. Defined as sum of the atomic masses of an atoms of an element in a molecule is called molecular mass. Now take example. Let you know example. Take the compound methane. Methane is molecular formula is CH4. So now observe how many atoms are is there? How many types of atoms are there? Two types. One is carbon and one more is hydrogen. Here there is only one carbon atom and four hydrogen atoms. Okay, now you get idea what is mean by atom. Here there is only one atom and four hydrogen atoms. One carbon atom and four hydrogen atom. There is two types of atoms. Now to calculate molecular mass of this molecule, we have to calculate atomic mass of each element. Now take first one, carbon. That is molecular mass of CH4 is equal to how many carbons are there? One carbon into the atomic mass of carbon is, you know, already we have find the average atomic mass of carbon by taking summation of three isotopes, carbon 12, carbon 13 and carbon 14. So there you get 12.011. That is the atomic mass of carbon 12. You get right there after summing the isotopes of three carbon, that is 12.011. And put plus, this is for water, this is for carbon. And how many hydrogens are there? Four into the atomic mass of hydrogen is, you know, basically we are finding 1.008. It means the beginning only we are finding the atomic mass of hydrogen is 1.008. Okay. So now multiply this one. 12.011 into 1, you get 12.011 plus 4 into 1.008. How much you get? 4.0484 is 32. This one. 4.032. You get this one. Now multiply these two, means sum, means add these two values. 12 plus 4 to get 16. Okay? Right? So, how much you get? 12.011 plus 4.032. So, 432. 340.62. That is 16.043. Atomic mass units are unified mass. Either you write AMU or U. This is the atomic mass of what? Methane. CH4, atomic mass of methane. Okay, similarly, we have to find for water or any compound. Now, let's take one more water. Now, this is example 1. Now, take example 2. Take water, H2O. Find the atomic mass of water. So, what to get? Here, there is two atoms. One is hydrogen and one more is oxygen. Now, the atomic mass of water is equal to molecular mass of water is equal to there is one two hydrogens, therefore 2 into what is the atomic mass of hydrogen? 1.008 plus there is only one oxygen, so 1 into, you know, the atomic number of oxygen is 8. Oxygen atomic number is 8. And it exists only one isotope. Therefore, and one isotope. And this oxygen is exist as molecule O2. O2 formula exhibit agutte diatomic formula. But we are taking here only one atom, one nascent oxygen, one oxygen. And the atomic mass is 8. Therefore, its mass number means molecular mass. Our mass number is into 2 means twice again. Because this the atomic mass is nothing but molecular mass is nothing but sum of protons and neutrons. Therefore, right, 8 into 2 means 16. That is twice. Okay, this is the atomic mass of molecular mass of hydrogen. Molecular mass of hydrogen. Now that is equal to our atomic mass of hydrogen, that is equal to 2 into 1.008 becomes 2.0016 plus 16 into 1 becomes 16. That is equal to 16 plus 2, 18. 18.016 atomic mass. This is the molecular mass of water. Molecular mass of water. So here 2 is the number of hydrogens. Hinto. Atomic mass of hydrogen is 1.008. Hinto. There is only one oxygen, therefore 1. Into the 16 is the atomic mass. Atomic mass, not atomic number, atomic mass of oxygen. You know the atomic number of hydrogen is 8. This is the atomic number. Atomic mass becomes twice of the atomic number. Atomic number is 8 ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ. Atomic mass is 8 rest ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, double ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. Therefore 8 2 is 16. That is we are writing here. Okay, now take one more example. Now take third one. Third example. Calculate molecular mass of glucose. So you know the molecular formula of glucose solution. We know that the molecular mass of the molecular formula of glucose is, what is the molecular formula of glucose? We are studying in 10th class. That is C6H12O6. This is the molecular formula of glucose. C6H12O6. Now, find the molecular mass. Therefore, molecular mass or molar mass, that is equal to, observe how many carbons are there? 6 carbons. So 6, that is equal to 6. Into, what is the atomic mass of carbon? Atomic mass of carbon is 12.011. Put plus, then hydrogen, 12 hydrogens. Into, what is the atomic mass of hydrogen? Atomic mass of hydrogen, that is 1.008. Plus, how many oxygens are there? 6 oxygens. 6 into, you know atomic mass of oxygen. In the previous problem we have written, that is atomic mass of oxygen is 88 into 16. Double of the atomic number. So atomic number double in the atomic mass again. That is 8 into 8 to the 16. Now multiply all these. 6 into 12 into 0.1, how much? 72. 12 6 is 72.11. How much you get? 0, 6 is. This is the multiplication. After multiplying this number, you get this much. Plus 12 into 0.18, that is 12.0. 12 8 is 84, that is 8.04. Plus 16, 6 is 36. 6 6 is 36. 3, 6 1 is 6 plus 3, 96. Okay, you get this much. Now add all these things. After add all these things, how much you get? That is 72.066 plus 12.084 plus 96. After adding all these terms, you get 180.162. 180.162. 162. After adding all these terms, you get 180.162. This is the unified mass or atomic mass units. This is the atomic mass of, sorry, molecular mass of, molecular mass of what? Glucose. C6H12O6. Like that, we are finding the molecular mass of an atom. Okay.